There are beings who have completely transcended all perceptions of matter. By the vanishing of the perceptions of sense reactions and by non-attention to the perceptions of variety, thinking space is infinite. They have attained to the sphere of infinite space. That is the fifth station. There are beings who, by transcending the sphere of infinite space, thinking consciousness is infinite. Having attained to the sphere of infinite consciousness, that is the sixth station. There are beings who have transcended the sphere of infinite consciousness, thinking there is nothing. Have attained to the sphere of nothing. That is the seventh station of consciousness. The two realms are the realm of unconscious beings, and secondly, the realm of neither perception nor non-perception. When you get into the fourth jhana, if you don't go any higher, but you gain real strong mastery of the fourth jhana and you die, there's two different heavenly realms that you can go to. One of them is a Brahmaloka, and the other one is the realm of being unconscious. You have a body that's like a statue, but there's no consciousness, no thinking. Now, some people have this idea that that's really, I don't want to be reborn there. That sounds like a hell realm. But there's so much relief in getting to the cessation of perception and feeling. Your body is still there. It's still, a heart's beating, still breathing, although faint, not very much. Your body stays alive. But there's no perception and feeling to disturb your mind. Now, when you become an anagami or an arahat, you will have the skill to go into that state anytime you want, just by making the determination. You make a determination that you want to stay in that state for so many days. No more than 7 days. Body can't live longer than 7 days without consciousness. Now, I've met one person that can do that. And it was a little Indian lady. You would never guess by seeing her on the street. She's just a normal looking person, kind of happy all the time, but normal looking. But you go into the same room with her, you know that you're walking into a room with a person that has a lot of personal power. I mean, a lot of personal power. And she started talking when I went in, and she started talking about being able to sit for 7 days in Nirodha Samapatti. That's the Pali term, but that's the cessation of perception and feeling. And being a dumb American, I said, why do you want to do that? And she gave me a one-word answer. Relief. There's no movement of mind at all. There's no vibration at all.